This morning we're especially proud and pleased to welcome the Honourable Jay Wetherill, Premier of South Australia, the Right Honourable Lord Mayor Martin Hazy, the legend that's Mick O'Loughlin, the co-founder of the Gough Foundation, Shirley Chowdhury, Chief Executive Officer of the Gough Foundation, and our special guest and man of the moment, Andrew Pridham, along with members of the Pridham family. A special nod to Andrew's dad, Bob, who's celebrating his birthday this week and has a birthday party today. The role of universities, in my view, is threefold. We generate knowledge through research, we transfer that knowledge through teaching to our students, and we engage meaningfully with the communities that we serve. The product of a university, if I can use that term, is the graduate. And at University of South Australia, we pride ourselves in educating modern professionals, graduates who are work ready and who add value to society. In my graduation addresses, I remind our graduates of the privilege that they enjoy through their education and how education brings with it responsibilities. One of those responsibilities is to give voice to the voiceless. Another is to help those who come after you. We have an expectation that our graduates will be talented people and that they put their talents to good use in life. So let me just talk briefly about one of our graduates and his talents. Andrew Pridham took his Bachelor of Applied Science in Property Resource Management and turned it into a phenomenally successful international career in commercial property and investment banking. His career has taken him to London as the global head of real estate for UBS. He returned to Australia and he established his own investment banking boutique before selling that to JP Morgan, which he then joined as the head of investment banking and ultimately the executive chairman of investment banking. He moved to New York where he established a joint venture with the investment bank Wellis and company, and they came back to establish and develop an Australian division based in Sydney. And while developing his outstanding career, Andrew joined the board of the Sydney Swans Football Club in 2002. Whether it was his influence that finally broke the team's 72-year premiership drought, the longest in AFL history, the Swans went on to become premiership champions in 2005 and then again in 2012. Andrew took over as chairman of the board of the Sydney Swans in 2013 when the Swans finished minor premiers and played off the 2014 premiership. I just know that every one of our students will be looking for a conditional pass now because their stuff has been blown away. We won't talk too much about this season because it's still a little bit too soon. But suffice to say, we're very proud of him and his contributions to business, to sport, and to his community. Now, as you know, we are all immensely proud of all of our alumni. We're proud because not only do they succeed in the careers that they choose, but they understand that education is that privilege and that it comes with that responsibility. And that responsibility to give back to community and to leave some of the opportunities that education has given them behind them. They do that through various means, most often using their position and influence to improve the lives of people who need a hand up in the form of scholarships, work experience, or job opportunity. But this man, Andrew Pridham, has gone above and beyond all who have come before him. He's about to present a $5 million philanthropic gift to the university that gave him his start. That gift is the largest single donation by a private individual in the university's 25-year history. The gift is to support the delivery of the university's Great Hall, which you can see under construction just across the road behind us here on Hindley Street West. The hall's existence stems from a unique conversation that we held 3 years ago in 2013 during our first uni jam. In that online discussion, thousands of our staff, our students and our alumni, gave voice to good ideas for the future of their institution. One of those ideas was to build our own Great Hall. The project quite literally was conceived by the university community. Andrew's gift helps us to turn that ambition into reality. And so it is very fitting that today we will name our Great Hall Pridham Hall. And it will be known as that in perpetuity and as a focus for everything that is important to us. A place for academic achievement where we'll celebrate our students' graduations. A centre for sport with multi-purpose courts, fitness centre and gym, and a 25-metre pool. And it will all be open to the public. But that's not all. Because we're celebrating academic achievement, sport, community engagement, and the role that education plays in improving lives, Andrew's gift has already inspired the state government to add a further $1 million to create two new perpetual scholarship programs here at the university. The first will support elite athletes, high-achieving sportspeople, to further their education at UniSA. The second is the Goods O'Loughlin UniSA Go Scholarship, which will recognise outstanding academic merit by high-achieving Aboriginal students and help fund their further education in the University of South Australia. Both Adam Goods and Mick O'Loughlin were marquee Swans players and played their entire careers with the Sydney team. They co-funded the Go Foundation to provide scholarships for Indigenous students to attend prestigious schools and to begin their journey into education that will open so many opportunities for them. It's wonderful to have such great South Australian success stories linked to our university in this way, in perpetuity. Andrew, Adam and Mick, each in their own way, through their generosity, their time, their energy, they exemplify the true meaning of philanthropy by putting what they have into the service of others. We all know that government money can only go so far and that gaps are filled by people with the means to do so. Philanthropy gives us more to work with. It allows us to bring more people along and ultimately it moves society forward. Andrew's gift has already catalysed the state government to augment it, and I know it will inspire others in like ways. In honour of our philanthropist Andrew Pridham, I would now like to give you a sneak peek at Pridham Hall via video. It is my sincere pleasure to introduce to you now Mr. Andrew Pridham.
Thank you, David. This is somewhat overwhelming. At the outset, I would just like to acknowledge my family who are here today, particularly my parents, Bob and Mary, my wife, Carolyn, and my children, Amelia, who graduated just a couple of weeks ago. I went to her graduation ceremony, which wasn't in a great hall, I can tell you that. It was Rose Hill Racecourse. It's good when you get there. My son Oliver, who's studying at UTS, and he's essentially studying the same degree that I did. And my daughter Grace, who is currently topping her class in kindergarten. Probably a future premier, I suspect. Thank you to Vice Chancellor David Lloyd and your very professional staff, particularly Deborah Heather Say, the University Council. It's a fantastic organisation to have dealt with, and it's been a pleasure for me and my family to reconnect with the university and have this opportunity. I certainly believe that UniSA is an institution that all South Australians should be very, very proud of, and I think it's largely your leadership. As a 17-year-old, I sat in the then 47-year-old Bonython Hall, which was the great hall of the University of Adelaide. It's another university here. It was an information day when I was contemplating studying law. I heard everything they had to say, and fortunately at that time I had an epiphany that the world had too many lawyers, apology, Premier. And I decided against this path, and that was a pretty good decision. But I was then left with a choice, what would I do? It appeared less likely that my chances of a professional football career with Nord or the Sydney Swans was going to come to fruition. Mainly they wouldn't return any of my calls. So I looked around and I thought property was the next best option, and it was really a fateful decision, and one I'm very, very grateful for and thankful that I made the decision to enrol at the South Australian Institute of Technology to undertake a degree in property resource management. And it's fantastic to see one of my lecturers here today, Peter Rossini, who I used to torment when I was a 19-year-old. Somehow he's got out of therapy and he's made it here today. So, and also to some of my classmates from back then who have remained lifelong friends. Rolling forward 33 years, it's difficult to comprehend and really impossible to imagine that the Great Hall of the University of Adelaide, just across the road here in Hindley Street West, which is going to be soon renamed University Street, or University Place, would be named Pridham Hall. We Pridhams have been in South Australia for a very, very long time, having arrived from England in 1849, just 13 years after government was proclaimed in South Australia in 1836. Back in 1849, South Australia, there were no universities, but there were also no Adelaide Crows or Port Power or speed cameras. So things were pretty good back then when we arrived. They were getting a bit shaky, but I think it's now back on track. So you're doing a great job, Premier. And thank you very much for coming here today and taking the time. Our family's long association with South Australia includes a very special bond with universities. And my father, Bob, who, the Vice Chancellor mentioned, turns 90 in a few days' time. Happy birthday. I didn't know what to get you, so I've got you a hall. He studied at the University of Adelaide and graduated in 1947 with a first-class honours in science. My brother, eldest brother David, has a degree from Flinders University in law, and my brother Richard, a Bachelor of Medicine and Surgery from the University of Adelaide. And likely my eldest sister Helen has a diploma from the South Australian Institute of Technology. My other sister Mary, I'm very proud of her. She works with underprivileged children, teaching as a nurse at St Peter's Collegiate Girls' School. So she's giving back as well. It's fantastic. So as you can see, we're a very egalitarian family. We were determined to take advantage and try out every single university in South Australia with our formal education, and it's been fantastic. And South Australia is more than just mines and vines. It's also about minds. And it is blessed, South Australia is blessed with great educational institutions. And the University of South Australia certainly stands out as the pick of the crop, in my opinion. And great educational institutions help develop great people, and they help people develop their full potential. And they help people do this by developing their minds, promoting new ideas and learning. And the great people make great universities. And my family are delighted to be associated with people such as David Lloyd and his fantastic staff at the university. What really also makes universities great is the infrastructure that houses them and provides the spaces that are vital to achieve what can be achieved by people, and this is crucial. Great buildings and infrastructure play a role in lifting the spirit and developing confidence and pride in people and inspiring them and creating mood and framing attitudes and defining atmosphere and culture. And I think the redevelopment of the Adelaide Oval is a very clear evidence of this, and as someone involved in the AFL, it's very clear to everyone outside of South Australia when they come here to beat Port or the Crows, to see what an impact the redevelopment of Adelaide Oval has had on the CBD and the vitality at night and the extra stride in everyone's step in South Australia, and it just really demonstrates what infrastructure can do. So buildings matter, and to create great infrastructure and great buildings takes planning, great foresight and great people. And the planning and now construction of the university's Great Hall would not have been possible without the vision of people such as Vice Chancellor David Lloyd, Chancellor Jim McDowell, and the council and the university. And great collaboration is necessary to conceive and to plan and deliver major projects. And these projects, as I said, will make a real difference in inspiring people. And I congratulate everybody involved. We're fortunate Our family are very fortunate to have the opportunity and the capacity to play a small role in delivering the Great Hall, and it is a small role compared to what others have done. I have no doubt it will be an inspiring building of undoubted design and excellence and innovation. I have great confidence that the University of South Australia itself, rated as one of the top 25 universities in the world under 50 years old, will continue to enhance its reputations as one of the finest and most innovative universities in Australia and I believe the world. And I'm hopeful that the Great Hall can play its part in that progress. In choosing to study a degree in property at the South Australian Institute of Technology over law, I took a contrarian view, a view that property had more upside than law. And that degree would prepare me better for the business world than would a law degree. And I think it's taking a contrarian view, which is something that I've always tried to do and pride myself on. I think when I joined the Swans board, Swans weren't very flavour of the month. We had Michael O'Loughlin, but not much else. I think Adam Goods was running around. And it just shows that in time how things can change. And I've got no doubt that supporting this project and this university, while some may see it as contrarian for someone in Sydney to give to a university in South Australia, I think it's a fantastic investment. And I like backing winners, and I recognise University of South Australia is a winner, and I have no doubt in years to come it won't just be known as one of the best universities in Australia, but it'll also be one of the most prestigious universities in South Australia. It is enterprising, it is young, it is modern, it's 32,000 students, 2,600 staff, and more than $600 million a year in turnover. You can chalk that up to 605 next year, Vice-Chancellor. certainly without the education I received, and it was a fantastic course, quite remarkable when I look back, 5 to 10 years ahead of any real estate course in the world at that time, I believe. And I certainly wouldn't have achieved what I've been able to without it. The Great Hall will be at the heart of the activities of the university in what is an increasingly vibrant Adelaide CBD. And it's noteworthy that it won't just serve for major occasions such as examinations and graduation ceremonies, but it will be part of the day-to-day life of students. In something that's very important to me, which is sport. And 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, it'll be open for sport. We live in a wonderful country where people, if they're willing to work hard, can achieve anything. And it's, as I've said before, it's an honour to have our family name associated with this building in the centre of Adelaide. And whilst I live in Sydney, my immediate family live in Sydney, I was raised on a diet rich in Woody's lemonade, Ditter's nuts, Hague's chocolates, Balfour's pies. It's a wonder I'm still alive, actually. and exotic family holidays to Victor Harbour, which we used to think was like going to Paris. But ultimately, it was my education at the University of South Australia that's really set me up for the balance of my life. And you should certainly never forget where you've come from, I believe. And I also believe you should take what you do very, very seriously, but don't take yourself very seriously. And I hope that's what frames me and my family. Supporting the Great Hall was an easy decision, but what wasn't an easy decision, paradoxically, was having the building named Pridham Hall, which I still have difficulty saying. By nature, our family are unassuming and reasonably quiet people. My family would probably argue that, with the exception of myself. But we have been part of the fabric of South Australia for 167 years. And I only hope that our donation can give inspiration to others who are fortunate enough to be able to give in any capacity, whether it's financial, time or expertise, to do so, because I think giving gives people a lot more satisfaction than accumulating. Our support as a family for education is because we believe everyone deserves the best possible education, and education is key to enabling young people to achieve the maximum of their potential. And we support sport because we believe sport is critical in building community, developing people's understanding of the importance of being part of a team. Sport brings people together and provides so much enjoyment to millions of people, and this is something I see at close quarters in my role with the Sydney Swans. And it was extremely exciting to me and to my family that the state government chose to augment our donation, the Pridham Foundation donation, to UniSA with its own $1 million contribution, which Mr. David already mentioned, to two perpetual scholarships. And I sincerely thank Premier Jay Weatherall for that gesture, and I know it will make a real difference. And The fact that one of the scholarships is being named the Adam Goods Michael O'Loughlin Go Aboriginal Sporting Excellence Scholarship for students wishing to study a sports and health science degree just rolls off the tongue, really. It's fantastic. You know, Adam and Michael, and I'm so delighted that Michael is here today, along with Shirley Chowdhury, who's the CEO of the Go Foundation. Thank you very much for coming, and you and Adam are very special to me, and to think that we've had played some part in a scholarship at this university, being named after the two of you means an enormous amount to me, and I owe you two a lot. Mainly, I had a massive hangover yesterday after we went out to dinner with Buddy on Thursday night, but anyway, that's another story. It's fantastic having you here, and UniSA, through SAIT, has been a leader in supporting the Aboriginal community since 1973, when the Aboriginal Task Force was established, and SAIT was the first tertiary institution in Australia to provide a specific course for Indigenous students. And when we consider the appalling statistics facing our Indigenous Australians in areas such as health, education, incarceration rates, life expectancy, employment prospects, anything that can be done to improve their lot and to help them have a better life, I'm all for, and I know what things that Michael and Adam do with the boys and girls in New South Wales in terms of their secondary education is making a real difference, and I'm hoping that this scholarship can also make a real difference. Just in finishing, I think it's somewhat symbolic that we're all here today, and that the eldest Pridham, my father Bob, who's almost 90, is here, and the youngest Pridham in our immediate family, Grace, who is 5. She's more excited about Halloween than this hall, but she's here. And my father was 10 when Bonython Hall opened, and Grace will be 7 when the Pridham Hall opens. And I really just hope, and something for everyone to reflect on, that in 83 years or so, Grace can have cause to come back to Adelaide, and she can walk past the Pridham Hall and look back and reflect on us all here today. And I think that one thing we can reflect on is, and the putting our name on the building is like leaving footprints in the sand, and that's something that I hope she remembers looking back when we're all long gone. I hope you all enjoy the hall. I hope the students have a ball in the hall. Mm-hmm. And it's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.
I had a big pen.
I've got a big bank account. Thank you very much. As I said earlier on, it's an amazing gift, it's inspiring, and we look forward to further honouring you tonight at the Alumni Awards dinner. But now I'd like to introduce the South Australian State Premier, whose generosity has added a further million to our scholarship funds. Please welcome Jay Weatherill, the Premier of South Australia.
And thank you, Vice-Chancellor, Lord Mayor, sporting champions, minor radio celebrities. Ladies and gentlemen, we're here to celebrate this extraordinary act of generosity from Andrew and his family. And in doing this, Andrew, you are demonstrating your values, your character, and obviously the values that your family also holds dear. And the first of those, of course, is extraordinary generosity. But also the notion of giving back when you've had a benefit yourself, and that's a wonderful lesson to teach not only your children but also the broader South Australian community. And it's wonderful to think that you do come from an old Adelaide family, and for me it's wonderful to think that they are deep values which are very much at the heart of South Australia and its experience. Of course, the choice that you've made by partnering with the University of South Australia, I think, is a wise choice and also a very powerful choice, because this institution was conceived as an institution which is directed at making a contribution to eliminating disadvantage. And it takes that part of its charter very seriously. Right from the start of this organisation, it has reached out into the areas of the South Australian community that are less fortunate. It has sought to engage people from Aboriginal communities, from the disadvantaged communities, particularly in the northern suburbs of our state, but has now, I think, established a very firm reputation as a leading institution in promoting equity. And so there's a nice synergy between your donation and this organisation. The other thing that I love about the University of South Australia is its ambition. It is an incredibly ambitious organisation. It is the first institution in line when there is an opportunity that presents itself. You can see by the extent of its building and construction program, both along North Terrace and now this side of North Terrace, that it is continuing to grow. And it seems its territorial ambitions have not ceased. It's continuing to agitate that we hand over a piece of government land across the road. And pretty soon it will overtake the whole of the west of the city of Adelaide. But that's a wonderful vision. And when we contemplate the future of our state, one of the things that struck me when we were putting together an economic plan is just how important our tertiary institutions are to the future of our state. You can make a case for suggesting that just about every part of our economic plan for South Australia is in some way touched upon by our tertiary institutions. And this institution is playing such an important leadership role. So you've chosen well, Andrew. But the other part of this announcement today, that the scholarships, is very exciting. It's great to have Michael here. And Adam Goods, I know, is very proud of his connection with this scholarship. And these are two, obviously, star footballers. But the great thing about them is they're South Australian. They started here in South Australia. And they haven't forgotten where they come from. They grew up in the northern suburbs. The northern suburbs are doing it tough. And they're going to face... they're doing tough already, and they're going to face additional challenges. And there's no group doing it tougher than the Aboriginal communities in the northern suburbs. So to be able to offer this is an offer of hope. It's saying to young Aboriginal students that they can aspire to excellence, and we will support them in that with this scholarship fund. And we're so proud to be partnering with you, Michael, and I hope you pass this on to Adam, and we look forward to having a whole lot more to do with you in the future. So, ladies and gentlemen, today is just an extraordinary act of generosity, both by Adam and Michael in coming back to South Australia and being part of their scholarship, by Andrew and his family coming back to South Australia and making this investment. And the Pridham family will be able to look at this and be reminded about the values that animated this decision. And I can't imagine a prouder monument to you and your family and what you stand for. So, congratulations.
Gracie, we're nearly finished with all the speeches, I promise. It's nearly over. I'm going to ask for your attention for one final video, which touches on the Go Foundation. Adam, at the moment, is on a bicycle. I think he's cycling across Australia. He did text the condition of his backside to me earlier on. He's hanging in there. Mick is here with us today, which we're very pleased to be able to share this great celebration with the Go Foundation founders. And I'm just going to show you a little video of the Goods O'Loughlin Go Foundation.
I'm very excited about the scholarship and partnership that we've made with the Go Foundation, the Goods O'Loughlin Foundation, with my great mate Mickey O, two proud South Australians, and the Uni of SA. Through the kind generosity, of a great man, Andrew Pridham, who also is the chairman of the Sydney Swans, and I've had a lot to do and work with him in the last 10, 15 years. And obviously Mr. Pridham is an alumni of Uni of SA, and it's great to see the people who have really earned all the knowledge that they got from UniSA into going into business and now giving back. I'm really proud of Andrew for doing that, but also the government, the Premier's office, the state office here in South Australia for their generosity and contributing to these Go Foundation scholarships here in Adelaide.
Yeah, it's been brilliant. And congratulations to Andrew Pridham, who's a great friend of ours, and we've known him for such a long time, a great supporter of the Go Foundation, and obviously the state government here and doing what they're doing. It's very important that these two, people come together with Andrew and certainly with the university to be able to create opportunities for not just Aboriginal people, but for everyone. Having kids attending school, finishing school, going on to university, getting that diploma, getting that master's degree, and certainly going on to bigger and better things and running organisations is what Adam and I are all about.
We're giving people who might not have been able to afford the opportunity to come to UniSA, that opportunity to get the same education that everybody else can get. And I think the generosity of some fantastic people in our community with a little bit of mentoring from hopefully the Go Foundation and this great institution in UniSA, we can really help develop these young minds and help them on their pathway to really making a difference in our community.
Thank you for giving up your Saturday morning to be with us here to celebrate a milestone in the university. The coincidence of it coming in our 25th birthday year is just a coincidence, but it's a happy one. And I hope you can enjoy the rest of the morning as we stay for morning tea. Thank you for your attendance, thank you for your generosity, and I hope you all have a wonderful day.